shopkeeper?
Yes, I am.
Do you regard yourself as a shopkeeper, a tailor, a psychologist? Which is it? Or all of them?
All three.
All three. Is this all your life? You've been...
21 years in Chatswood.
In this shop?
11 years on this corner and 10 years in the arcade.
Is it a good life? You, I guess you wouldn't do it if it wasn't.
That's right. I enjoy people.
Yeah?
I enjoy what I do.
And
we also have that place across the road there too, so that's tailoring.
Tailoring.
On the spot.
But did you start in retail or did you start in tailoring? Where did you...
Where did I start originally? No, I started in retailing.
Yeah?
Originally.
And menswear because?
No, I had my own business many years ago when I was a young fellow. Started in food, and then I went into clothing.
And is clothing better than food?
I thought 5 days a week is better than 7 days.
Right, that's true.
And then it was the other way around later on.
And so now you're still working 7 days?
Now I have a place that I have people working 7 days.
But you don't have to?
I don't have to.
What are you looking forward to? I mean, you've got a good business, you're going to sell it, you're going to walk out?
Oh, I've got my eldest son working for me for the last 11 years, plus he's doing the buying at the moment in Melbourne. Mm-hmm. What I'll do is it accountant, economics, finance, his real estate, his clothing. Okay. I'll leave that to them. Yeah. It's time for me to spend time with my grandson and my wife.
You have a wife? You remember?
Oh, yeah, I remember that I have a wife.
Does she work with you?
No.
So
not when you have five children.
No. What has business been all your life? Business
has been my life since I was... I was born on flight coming over here about 1952.
On a flight?
On a flight. Okay. KLM, the Royal Dutch Airlines, Pontiac Constellation, a Super Constellation, half an hour before Miller Airport. My parents went into retail and their businesses are still there in Roselle.
Where were they from? Where were you flying from?
We're coming from Beirut to Sydney.
Yeah.
And I was born half an hour before Miller.
The whole family is very business oriented, successful, but to what extent has business ruled your life?
Business really did overtake my even my social life for a few years and for many years. But I've worked out there is time for work, time for socialising, and time for living. Because you don't know if you're going to be here the next day or the year after or the week after.
Yeah. Does it? So, when you were really in the grip of work, how much time did you have for your wife and your kids?
I always made time for my wife and my children, always.
So that was never an issue?
That was the top issue, yeah. Business came second. Family came always first.
Were there any times when you had to make a decision, a choice?
Oh, there was many times you had to make choices. Sometimes you had to sacrifice a bit of their time, but you made up for their, as long as you went and spent time with them. Yeah, when they were growing up, the eldest is 26 and I'm 49 just 2 days ago.
So that was a conscious decision?
Well, I wanted to be...
You wanted to be around for them?
Well, a little bit longer.
Yeah.
Haven't got a very good record on my side of the family.
Uh-huh.
Yeah.
So you wanted to get married, but you had to find a lady first?
She found me.
Yeah? Tell us about it.
Let's see, she was... she had come out about 1970, I think.
From
Lebanon.
Yeah.
Even though that I grew up here, I... plenty of friends and girlfriends and things like that, but I decided I wanted to marry someone that I looked at a couple of times, but she ended up saying, come on, let's go down the aisle, let's go.
Uh-huh.
She was only about 16 and a half and I was 20, and both got married then.
And she said, let's do it.
She said, let's do it now, and I said, oh, a couple of years from now.
What about her parents?
Her parents?
They must have agreed.
Oh, they agreed straight away when they knew.
They could see quality, could they?
Oh, they could see it's all from the person. Doesn't have to be fantastic, good looking or anything like that. They've got a good heart.
Yeah.
And you know where this person is going to lead you. You know you want to spend all your life with that person. That's it.
Patrick.
Patrick. Is that an Irish name?
Yes,
I mean, it is an Irish name, but are you Irish?
No, I'm not Irish.
No. Not. Where are you from?
I was actually born in Fremantle.
Oh, yeah.
And I moved here when I was about five.
Yeah.
So I can't actually recall it. I've lived in this area all my life. I work at
this here Pitt being
Junction. Mossman, Pitt Junction. Worked there. I moved to Adelaide for a year, tried something different, but that didn't
work.
Didn't eventuate.
Yeah.
But it was.
Do you like Sydney?
I love Sydney. Yeah. I think Sydney's a wonderful and beautiful, picturesque place. I've been to Seattle. I've been to England. I've been to a fair few places. I try to go every couple of years.
Yeah.
You
come back here.
And I come back here.
Do you live in a house, a flat?
I live with my mother.
Yeah.
She's 68 now.
Yeah.
I've never been married. Yeah. Maybe I'm a bit shy or too fussy. One of the two.
Or both.
Or both. But it seems to be working quite well.
Yeah.
Maybe it's security and comfort, I suppose.
Yeah. But have you always lived with your mum?
No, I lived by myself down in Harbord for about 12 years.
Yeah.
And then my father died.
Yeah.
Heart attack. And my mum was living up in Queenscliff and kind of drifted back there.
Before that, you were living on your own?
Yeah.
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 So now, do you look after your mum or does she still look after you?
I tend to think she looks after me, but
a bit of both.
She's a real talker. She likes talking and communication, and she likes getting outdoors.
Yeah. Do you take her out?
I take her shopping, and we do go for a walk.
Yeah.
Because I'm postman, I'm delivery, so I do a lot of walking and more walking on the weekends.
Yeah. And so obviously you have a good relationship with your mum.
Yeah, yeah.
What do you talk about? What does she like to talk about?
Current
affairs, or is it?
Yeah, she talked about politics.
Yeah.
She's, I think, second generation Greek.
Yeah.
And she, I don't know. They just, is it something? When you're born that way, you like talking and communications and family.
Yeah. And you like to listen.
I listen. She reads a lot of books. Mm-hmm. She's a prolific reader. She most likely goes through about half a dozen books a week.
Yeah.
And she's been doing that ever since I've known her. So she gets stuck on subjects.
Ever since you knew her, she's a long time.
She gets stuck on subjects and she's kind of in there for life.
Yeah.
She's reading, Afterlife and tarot cards. She looks at those things she says there's a lot of shonks in the new age, but she enjoys it.
Yeah. We've been talking about your mum. What about your dad?
My dad worked in the bank for 40 years.
Uh-huh.
Had a heart attack. Had the bypass and didn't pull through. It's a bit of surreal kind of experience. You go to see your father, you kind of walk in the hospital to see how he is, and he's not here. Oh, where is he? Sorry, but he's passed on. I suppose it's very upsetting and kind of reserved. You feel like they're always going to reappear, and they don't.
Yeah.
My mum went to actually see him when he was dead. I couldn't.
You couldn't?
I would have liked to, but, I've had enough times with him to kind of say goodbye and hello.
Yeah.
And if there is an afterlife, we'll meet up there.
Do you reckon there is?
My mum does, I don't.
She reckons there is.
But I'm not, I don't fear death. I think, I didn't fear before I was born. I'm not going to fear when I die. It's always brave, and you can be brave now, but when close, say you're on your dying bed, you might be kind of turning your head saying, God, how are you? remember me? I wasn't that bad, was I?
Tricky job. At the moment, the poster is winning.
No, it's not very fun.
Maybe it'll be a creative angle.
Well, you know, we're not artists here at the bank, are we?
I beg your pardon?
We're not artists here at the bank.
Oh, I don't know. You're,
I'm not. Okay, here. You look
This is more like a wrestling match, isn't it?
Yes, pretty much, yeah.
Very good. All you have to do is, it's looking good. But a little crinkle doesn't matter, you know, it sort of looks homemade.
We're not doing good now.
Adds a touch of humanity, you know, personality.
This is sad.
Would you like a hand? No, I'd probably ruin it. I'm not very handy.
Yeah. Yes, we're probably better than you. Okay.
That's getting good.
See? Look, I'm coming good here. You're gonna have to pick up your game show.
Yeah, if this was a game show, you would have exceeded your time limit.
I'm sure.
Very,
well, how do you think? What do you think about the bubbles in there?
Well, it's not absolutely 100% straight, but I don't think you need worry about that.
It's come a long way since we started, hasn't it?
Yes.
Now we're winning.
Now you're winning. Now it's actually, look, it's straight-ish and smooth-ish. And people can read it, that's the main thing.
Yeah. Yeah, how about you? Are you interested in one of our home loans?
What color are they?
We could do one in blue.
Your name is Robin.
Yes.
My name's Andrew.
Hi, Andrew.
Do you sell home loans yourself? Is that what you do?
No. I refer people who want a home loan on to someone else.
So what do you normally do when you're not sticking up posters?
I live for the bank.
Yeah, I know, but what?
Oh, besides that?
At the bank.
Oh, at the bank. Oh, open up new accounts and advise people on banking.
Right.
That sort of thing.
Are you a banker by, like, is this a career option?
I'm not really a career girl, no. I only do this 3 days a week.
Oh, do you? And the other 4 days of the week?
The rest of it, I think about it
yes.
a lot.
Do
and,
you?
preparing myself for
Oh, look,
my
you have
days.
An assistant straightening out the...
Thank you, Genevieve.
Yes.
I work there as well on the break.
You're the bubble straightener, the bubble...
Yeah, she's good at that.
Yeah. And so... 3 days a week. Why 3 days a week? Do you have children or?
Yeah. I've got a son. Yeah.
A son.
So.
How old is son?
A son. He's nearly 8 in March. Yeah.
So the rest of the time you look after him?
Look after him, play tennis on Tuesday, have a tennis clinic on Wednesday, and do family things on Saturday, Sunday.
And your husband is banker?
He's in America. We're divorced. Yes.
You're American too.
Yeah, yeah.
Did you leave America to come here?
No, I left America with him to move here.
Yes.
And then we said, see ya, and he went back.
Soon after you got here?
Not too soon after, about maybe 6 years after.
But so it had nothing to do with Australia that you split up?
No, not really, no. But now I've got an Aussie man, so I'm staying.
Have you? And you still have an American accent?
Yes, I think so.
You don't want to lose it?
I don't.
No.
I
what part of America are you from?
Kansas City.
Kansas City. Famous Kansas City.
Sort of, yeah.
Sort of? Well, it's,
you
know,
more famous
songs
parts.
And things.
Yeah, everything's up to date in Kansas City.
Yeah, is that
I think
true?
That's what you're thinking. It is.
Yeah?
It's all up to date, yeah. They've gone and built a skyscraper 20 stories high.
Now, that's Kansas City is where you were born and raised.
That's right,
yeah.
That's right.
And where you met your first Mr. Man?
Met the first one. Yeah. Mr. Wrong.
Mr. Wrong.
Met
it took you a while to figure this out.
Quite some time.
Yeah.
And then moved from Kansas City, we moved to Atlanta and lived there for 5 years. We just go to Olympic cities pretty much. And then here.
Right.
And then here. So I've been here 9 now.
Yes. How did you meet that first Mr. Wrong?
Mr. Wrong? We met actually at a bar. He was working at, you know, one of those sort of American bars called Studebakers, where they go and dance to 50s tunes and stuff. He was the DJ. And I thought he was quite cute. He was like doing Elvis or something. And I thought he was quite cute. And he was cute, but anyway.
You were young and impressionable.
Young and impressionable. I went up and requested a song, tried to chat with him.
Yes.
And then he said, I went up a couple of times requesting songs. And then later he said to me, I'm going to play a slow one. come up and dance with me on the slow one. And I went, oh. And when he played a slow one, I was in the hugest queue for the toilet. I had to go so bad. And I heard Meatloaf, 2 out of 3 ain't bad. Come on. And I went, amazing out there. And we had a dance.
You had a dance. All while you were busting.
I was busting. I was busting. And I was trying to hold it in my stomach, but...
Did something happen during the dance? Did you feel that maybe this was...
Digging him. I was digging him big time.
Yes?
Yeah. And he was digging me.
Yeah. What was wrong?
Lots of things.
Lots of things.
Yeah. Lots of
wasn't
things.
Wasn't the simple...
Probably the biggest thing was financial. What's it good?
Yeah. Are you a conservative financially?
I'm a bit of a spender, and so is he, and that's good. That's bad when you get two spenders.
Uh-huh.
Usually you need the good cop, bad cop.
Yeah.
And we were both spenders.
Yeah.
So that wasn't any good.
So there wasn't much left to spend very quickly.
No.
Yeah.
And it doesn't make for a happy life.
And that caused friction?
That caused friction, yeah. And also we're both big flirters, so that wasn't good either.
So there was all sorts of trouble.
I think so.
And lots of friction and fighting about those issues?
Kind of, yeah, a lot of that. We did a bit of counselling, that sort of thing. This is much later in the relationship. Yeah.
But then at what point did you or he call it quits?
Perhaps I called it quits. It was me. And I did it because, you really want to know? Because I was having an affair. And
and you felt this was probably a good time to say
it. I thought, when I first started having the affair, right, because I was unhappy in the marriage and this sort of thing, when I first started having the affair, I always was going to maintain the marriage and the child because I thought, I'll have the image of the happy family and still...
have it all.
Yeah, get some on the side.
Yeah.
And then just as the affair progressed through years, I decided I'd go.
Right. So what did you tell him?
I told him the truth.
Yeah.
It took me about 3 or 4, about the same time as our first date, to tell him. It took me about 3 days to actually, I planted the seed, I laid the pavers, and then told him on about day 3. So the first 2 days, lots of crying and saying I'm not happy, and he kept saying about what and all this sort of thing, and then I finally said. And he knew the guy, because he's a close friend of ours, and he said, is it Pete? I said, yeah.
What did he say?
There's Pete. There's Pete.
He's in the car. Can't see him
there. There he goes. I just noticed him. Just noticed his number plate. What did he say? He was pretty pissed off.
Is Pete the guy that you're with?
They're
now?
Both Petes.
Are they both Petes?
Yeah, so it makes it easier. I only go with Petes.
So this Pete.
That's Pete number 2.
Oh, this is the
Pete. That's the good Pete.
Oh, this is the Pete that you're with now.
That's the one I'm with now, yes. The ex is also a Pete. I'd like to keep it easy for myself.
But is this Pete the same Pete as you were having an affair with?
That's the guy.
That's the guy, okay.
That's the guy.
What is your son's name?
Xander.
Oh, thank goodness.
Yeah, no.
What's his name?
Thank goodness for that, too. Xander, the last half of Alexander. We call him Xander.
Xander. So where did he fit into all this? How did he cope with two Petes?
He's a very adaptable child, and he always just thought the one Pete and I were good friends.
Mm.
You know, he used to call him, before he had that blue Jeep, he had a green Jeep, and he used to call him Pete with the green Jeep.
That sort of clarifies the thing.
Yeah, that was how he felt about Pete. He was Pete with the green Jeep.
And now how's the relationship between them?
Oh, they're great. They're excellent.
Does he see his father?
His father moved almost a year ago now. And so, no, we haven't been to America, and his dad hasn't been back
and
here.
And what's the relationship with Pete 1?
And Xander?
Yeah, and you. I mean, is it amicable?
Pete 1.
I mean,
I try to have it be, but it's hard sometimes.
Yeah.
But, the last couple phone conversations have been nice.
What about the two Petes? Do they still...
They don't speak.
They don't speak?
No.
Wasn't good for the friendship then?
No, not really, no. And the bad Pete says really irresponsible things to my son, like, oh, I don't like Pete, he stole your mom from us, and that sort of thing.
So he took it fairly badly?
Bad Pete?
Mm.
Oh, yeah. I suppose anyone would have.
Yeah.
But he wasn't perfect either.
No.
Of course. And then it came, lots of things came out after.
Yes. And does he have anyone now?
He is remarried, and they're expecting a baby. The baby was supposed to come on February 2nd, and hasn't come yet. But yeah, he's moved quick.
Yes.
Hasn't he? Pete and I don't even live together.
Uh-huh.
But I left my husband for the affair. Now we're living down the street. The husband has gone off, got a new wife, and he's getting ready to have a baby.
Do you think that'll make a difference to the way he responds and relates to you and to Xandra?
Hopefully it'll soften him a bit,
yeah.
Although he still, even after everything, has a whole lot of hostility towards me.
Yeah.
And it only makes me think that he must not have moved on,
yeah,
if he still has this, you know, hostile attitude towards me.
Yeah.
Because if he didn't care anymore,
mm,
if he'd moved on, I think he'd be amicable, but
Something tells you that.
Yeah, by his nastiness,
yeah,
I can tell that,
yeah,
he probably must still have feelings. And I think what I did to him, with the friend and the affair,
yes,
is a major blow to his ego that he can't recover from.
Right. What about good Pete, new Pete, and how he felt about the affair at the time? Did he must have been going through a few strange,
yeah,
emotions.
Yeah, and we always agreed pretty much that we weren't going to come out with the affair. But then as time
it
passed,
became more,
we loved each other.
Yeah.
Yeah. And,
yeah,
and I was always going to go home. It was just going to be easier for me. I said to Bad Pete at the time, let's just move home. I,
yeah,
said, let's just move back to the States and stuff. And he wondered where it was coming from. But we started going along the steps to move back to the States. And then one day, and I call it that day in May, that Good Pete and I were just having a chat and I was crying my eyes out saying, I'm moving home, I can't deal with this. He said, why is everyone else's happiness more important than yours? Why is Xandra's happiness and Pete's,
yeah,
happiness and your parents, the image of their married daughter and,
yeah,
this sort of thing, more important than your own? And I thought, that's true.
Mm.
It is true. So I selfishly did what it took to make myself happy. But now everyone else is happy too. I mean, Xander's happy.
Mm.
Bad Pete is hopefully happy.
And you?
And I'm definitely happy.
You're definitely happy. Oh, hello. You're not too much of a hurry to talk to us, are you? You're not too shy or anything?
I'm not too shy,
not too
but
shy.
What's it all about?
It's a documentary for SBS.
SBS, okay.
SBS,
yes.
Is,
yep,
that okay?
Fine. I'll just stand behind you.
Where are you heading? Where are you heading?
Heading home.
Heading home from work?
No. Just from
sauntering.
From sauntering.
My name's Andrew, by the way.
Hi, Andrew.
I'm Steve.
Steve.
I'm Melissa.
Alicia?
Melissa.
Oh, Melissa. Are you also sauntering or? You're sauntering together.
I'm sauntering along with him. He's,
yes,
husband.
He's your husband. And you're not at work?
No, not today.
It's day off.
Day off. What were you doing in the middle of Melbourne?
Oh, just doing
shopping,
that's all.
Yeah.
That's all.
Do you normally work? Do you have a...
No, I don't work.
You don't work? Do you work?
I work at Maya.
And you're not today?
No, it's the day off today.
Is it a special occasion?
No, not really. No, just a normal day off. Working in hospitality, you get time off during the week. So.
Right. And you don't work at all because you don't like work or because you don't want work?
I'll work, but when the right time comes,
yeah,
in the right circumstances.
What do you do, can we ask?
I've got no qualifications. I do nothing except like you.
So what do you like to do?
What do I like to do? I like to read, walk and make music.
With what? What do you make music with?
I play guitar and just play with a few friends.
Do you sing?
No, I leave that to the people who can.
People, boys, do you sing?
Badly.
Badly?
Yeah, yeah. No, not very
You
much.
Can sing, you're a good singer.
No.
I've heard you.
No, just around the house sort of thing.
Tell us
about
this.
Embarrassing.
How long have you been married?
8 months.
Yeah.
Fairly recent.
Yeah, pretty recent.
And what about, how long have you known each other?
Oh, about just under 2 years.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Did you get married? You know, some people just live together.
Mm-hmm.
And some people get married.
Yeah.
You got married. Was there a reason? Something compelled you?
No particular reason. We just sort of met and knew we were the right people for each other and thought.
You just knew
that.
It.
Yeah.
We'd stopped looking, didn't care anymore,
yeah,
and then,
yeah,
it suddenly happened,
yeah,
which is the best way.
Yeah.
I think.
Where exactly did that take place? Where did you actually physically meet?
Oh, this is a story. Do you want to say it?
We met on New Year's Eve.
Yeah.
About 2 years ago at a pub in Fitzroy called The Standard. And, I had a few too many wines and was sort of giving kisses to everyone in the room. And he was the last one to leave. And I said, I had all these kisses on the cheek. I haven't had any on the lips, so it's going to be you. So.
And so, that was just it as far as we were concerned. And we met by sheer coincidence a month later at a different pub and decided, well, we shouldn't lose touch again. And, of course, turned out really well.
So that kiss was actually...
It started with a kiss.
But then there was a little gap.
It was a gap.
And you accidentally met again.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Just by chance.
Just, I was walking up the street and there Melissa was sitting with her friend. And I went over and said, were you at this pub on New Year's Eve? And she said, oh yeah, you're the one I molested.